الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمدك اللهم سبحانك كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. نحمدك اللهم آناء الليل وأطراف النهار، معترفين بسلطانك، حامدين شاكرين لنعمائك. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يديم علينا نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة، وأن يلهمنا العزم والعزيمة والصبر والثبات على أن نحمده على تلك النعماء. اللهم أمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يحيي ويميت، وهو حي لا يموت، وهو على كل شيء قدير، شهادة قامت بها السماوات والأرض. أدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى ألا يحرمنا إياها لحظة لقائه. اللهم أمين. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. اللهم اجزه عنا خير ما تجزي به مرسلا ونبيا. اللهم شفعه فينا شفاعة لا نعذب بعدها أبدا. اللهم اسقنا من حوضه شربة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم أمين. اللهم أمين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our sons and daughters, the future of Islam, inshaAllah رب العالمين. I'm sure that some of you, if not all of you, have heard about something might happen. Definitely, certainly it will happen this coming Monday, August 21st, few days. What has been known, scientifically speaking, the total solar eclipse of 2017. كسوف الشمس الكلي. And some people might be wondering why this would be the topic of our Friday sermon today. You'll be amazed and you'll be wondering if NASA and science and scientists and all of those people who are involved in such a thing are talking about it from the scientific point of view. They're telling us even per second what would happen, when it will happen, where it will happen, and how it happens, and how we can see it. And they're telling us about all the details of that total solar eclipse. And the question would be, does Islam talk about such a thing? A lot of people who believed in science and technology and the advanced scientific, you know, discovery and explanation say, wow, you know, this is a big deal. But how about Islam? You will be amazed. You will be surprised. How Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 1400 years ago talked about it and told us what to do and what we'll be expecting and what we should be doing and relating to such a thing happening in our universe. Ya Rasulullah, Ya Habib Allah, Al-Mustafa, Al-Nabi, Al-Rasul, you told us about the total solar eclipse and the lunar eclipse, not only يعني كسوف الشمس but أيضا كسوف القمر. Solar and lunar eclipse, partial or total? Yes, we'll see. InshaAllah رب العالمين. Let's start with the science first. You'll be excited, you'll be happy. As I mentioned, Yeah, some people would say, you know, why we talk about such a thing? This is Majlis Iman. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And we follow up what is going on. We raise the awareness of what is going on around us and what we should do, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, because you will be happy, you'll be surprised, you'll be wondering during that eclipse and after what we should be doing as Muslims. There is a salah called Salatul Kusuf or Salatul Khusuf. Salah, like our salah. The salah of the lunar eclipse and the salah of solar eclipse in Islam, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. On August 21st, 2017, America will fall under the path of a total eclipse. What they called the Great American Total Solar Eclipse here in America, not anywhere else, in specific states. I'll mention this to you, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, where and when, in order for us maybe would be able to watch it somehow. What is the total solar eclipse first, according to the science and the scientific and NASA? A total solar eclipse occurs when the disk of the moon appears to completely cover the disk of the sun in the sky. The disk of the moon totally covering the disk of the sun. You cannot see the sun. So that's why we'll see during that total eclipse, it's totally dark. No sun, no light, no nothing. Subhanallah. It gives a lot of dimensions and a lot of measures and so on and so forth. It goes even to the millimeter of what is happening. And this is the beauty of the science. We do enjoy, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. What will I see during the total solar eclipse? During that eclipse, again, the disk of the moon blocks out the last sliver of light from the sun. Science telling us. Where will the total solar eclipse would be visible? The path of totality for the August 21st, 2017 total solar eclipse is about 70 miles wide. 70 miles wide. And it stretches from Oregon to South Carolina. It passes through Idaho, Wyoming, Nebraska, Kansas, Missouri, Illinois, Kentucky, Tennessee, Georgia, North Carolina, and South Carolina. Minnesota is not included. I know some people are planning to travel to the closest state in order to watch and observe that total solar eclipse, subhanallah. When will the total solar eclipse occur and how long will it last? It depends on each state for how long this would be there, from even a fraction of second beginning, and then the total, and then when is about to end gradually till it is totally gone. The closest one to us, I don't have to mention all of them to you, but the closest state to us, Illinois, and this will be at the city of Carbondale, Illinois. The eclipse begins there 11:52 a.m. The totality begins at 1:20 p.m. and the totality ends at 1:22. The totality would last only for a couple of minutes. But the phase before and the phase after would be much longer than the totality. And then the eclipse ends at 2:47 p.m. 2:47 p.m. So beginning 11:52 ends at 2:47. This is what the science have been telling us in that wonderful way of the discovery of those wonderful scientists in that field, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Do I need any equipment to view the eclipse? There is a lot of recommendations saying that any planning to view the total solar eclipse should get a pair of solar view glasses. You can find it somewhere if you can order it, and if you do have time to order it and you get it. When is the next time a total solar eclipse will be visible from the United States? 2024. In 7 years, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extend our life, you will see it again in 7 years. Total solar eclipse in the United States of America. We may ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to extend our life to watch this total solar eclipse. That this is the scientific point of view about that solar, total solar eclipse. What Islam is telling us about it. So amazing. So amazing. 1400 years ago. And this is the beauty of Islam and the marvelous point about Islam and the greatest things about Islam. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam never went to NASA in Mecca or in Medina at that time to be a scientist in that field to tell us more and more about it. Or to tell us what to do. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. That's why when I'm saying you'll be wondering, you'll be amazed of what Islam is teaching us about such a thing. And not only to teach us about that solar and lunar eclipse, but what to do. What to do during such a thing. Especially when it comes to as a sunnah mu'akkada. It is emphasized sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to perform that salatul kusuf lil qamar lil shams or salatul khusuf lil qamar sunnah mu'akkada. But how? This is what we'll see inshallah rabbil alamin, and you'll be amazed. It's totally different. It is not in big part of it similar to the salah we're performing, but there is some additional things in that salah we do. And you'll be surprised, subhanallah, rabbil alameen, why is that? Why is that? Our reference, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, fiqh sunnah. Alhamdulillah. Sheikh Sayyid Sabiq, rahimahullah. In salatul kusuf, it came under that big part of that fiqh sunnah about the different types of salah. Salah, the regular salah, or salatu qiyamul layl, or salatu tawbah, or salatul khawf, or salatul, you name it. But big part of it about salatul kusuf, the prayer of the solar eclipse or the lunar eclipse. I'll share with you some of what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about. الأفضل أن تصلى في جماعة in the masjid. It's a working day, of course. We are busy. But if you can do it, this would be in your record of wonderful good deeds. You will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, Ya Allah, I have heard about it. I have witnessed it. I read about it. I learned about it in our masjid. And here I am. I'm performing that salat. كسوف الشمس in جماعة in مسجد الإمام or any مسجد around if the other مساجد perform the صلاة there. ركعتان two ركعة. But here is the most amazing part. في كل ركعة ركوعان. في كل ركعة ركوعان. You go to the prayer, Allahu Akbar, تكبيرة الإحرام. Reading, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he read in one of those prayers, subhanAllah, he finished in the first rak'ah, Surah Al-Baqarah. Long reading. And then have the first ruku' long one. وَسُبْحَانُ رَبِّيَ الْعَظِيمُ سُبْحَانُ رَبِّيَ الْعَظِيمُ دُعَاء and so on and so forth. And stand back from the ruku' and another long reading of the Qur'an. And then the second ruku' which is very totally different from our regular prayer in Salat al-Janazah, no ruku' no sujood. In Salat Kusuf al-Shams wa Kusuf al-Qamar, two ruku' subhanAllah. Each has its own characteristics, subhanAllah ya Rabbil Alameen. Where we get all of this, it is in the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha wa ardaha. خسفت الشمس في حياة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فخرج رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى المسجد فقام فكبر وصف الناس وراءه فأقرأ قراءة طويلة ثم كبر فركع ركوعا طويلا هو أدنى من القراءة الأولى ثم رفع رأسه فقال سمع الله لمن حمده ربنا ولك الحمد ثم قام فأقرأ قراءة طويلة هي أدنى من القراءة الأولى ثم كبر فركع ركوعا هو أدنى من الركوع الأول ثم قال سمع الله لمن حمده ربنا ولك الحمد ثم سجد ثم فعل في الركعة الأخرى مثل ذلك حتى استكمل صلاة كسوف الشمس. That's Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم what he did. تكبيرة الإحرام الفاتحة read almost سورة البقرة long reading have the first ركوع long ركوع and then stand from that ركوع and then read longer but less longer than the first one and then had the second ركوع and stand up and of course after each ركوع stand up سمع الله لمن حمده ربنا ولك الحمد then the sujood. This is the first rak'ah, second rak'ah, the same Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is so amazing part we should be aware of. On the death of Ibrahim, the son of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, subhanAllah, the same day, there was a lunar eclipse, partial lunar eclipse. كسوف القمر. Some people around Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم thought and said that lunar eclipse happened due to the death of the son of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم came out immediately and say, لا إن الشمس والقمر آيتان من آيات الله عز وجل. لا ينخسفان لموت أحد ولا لحياته فإذا رأيتموهما فأفزعوا إلى الصلاة. الله أكبر يا رسول الله. That's what he said. When people claim that, oh, this is what happened because of the death of the son of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Definitely, certainly, without any doubt, sun and moon are two signs of the many signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this universe. Never, never had eclipse in either one of them because of the death of anyone. Never happened. Or the life of anyone. You know, to celebrate his life or to recognize his death. If you witness such a thing, the lunar eclipse or the solar eclipse, فَأَفْزِعُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ rush to the prayer. It didn't say just come or please, يعني perform. No. فأفزعوا. That's why at the beginning when I said, according to that reference, alhamdulillah, فقه السنة, it is سنة مؤكدة عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Emphasize سنة. It means we have to do it. We should do it. We must do it. فأفزعوا إلى الصلاة. This is what رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. It is in البخاري ومسلم and in some other روايات عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. كسفت الشمس وصلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقام قياما طويلا نحو من سورة البقرة ثم ركع. Till the end of the hadith as we have mentioned before. This is Ibn Abbas is telling us about such a thing. In both hadith Ibn Abbas and hadith Aisha رضي الله عنهما وأرضاهما, Ibn Abdul Barr, one of the greatest scholar of the hadith, said that هذان الحديثان من أصح ما روي في هذا الباب. And these two hadith, the most incredible hadith narrated by Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. One of the greatest reference, يعني no buts, no ifs about those hadith. يعني you can say حسن ضعيف, no. It's incredible hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. ابن القيم said السنة الصحيحة الصريحة المحكمة في صلاة الخسوف تكرار الركوع في كل ركعة لحديث عائشة وابن عباس وجابر وأبي بن كعب وعبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص وموسى الأشعري كلهم روى عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تكرار الركوع في الركعة الأولى. ابن القيم also is telling us something about that phenomena and that hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and the solar and the lunar calendar of the two ruku'a in each rak'ah. Because some people would be amazed. And why two ruku'a? Why not extra sujood? Instead of sujood, make it four. Or five. Make it one in here. Don't ask me this question. And if you raise that question, no answer. This is the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To give it that specific characteristics of the solar and lunar eclipse, it has to be done this way. If you say three ruku', make it three ruku'. No ruku' at all in Salat al-Janazah, no ruku'. No sujood, no sujood. Sometimes the reason or the justification is there, we're not supposed to know everything. Leave it to Allah and leave it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لازلنا في رحاب المصطفى البر لا يبلى والذنب لا ينسى والديان لا يموت كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون والتائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الله صلاة وتسليما يليقان بالحبيب المصطفى النبي المجتبى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وتابعيه وتابعي تابعيه إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our dear sons and daughters, the future of Islam, inshallah رب العالمين. Allah, some people, as I mentioned before, and why would bring such a topic to discuss it? Like last week, why I brought the topic of what happened in Dar al-Faruq when someone came to the masjid and implanted an explosive bomb there. This is us here, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, in Majl al-Iman. Wallahi, last week and this week, I was preparing to talk about Eid al-Adha and Sayyidina Ibrahim involvement in such a thing, in order to have a series of sermons, Friday sermon, till we reach Eid al-Adha. Subhanallah, Rabbil Alameen. When something happened, we have to be updated. And most importantly, we have to bring what is happening to the Islamic viewpoint in order to be guided, not to be misled by anyone. What happened in Dar al-Faruq, put it in its Islamic perspective. What is happening of the total solar eclipse, we have to refer it to Islam in order not to be, sometimes some people, subhanAllah, be fascinated by what the science is saying or NASA is saying, but we do not know what Islam is saying. Especially nowadays, subhanAllah, Rabbil Alameen, some people would say, Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's secondary. We don't have to put a lot of emphasis. No, wallahi. حبك لرسول الله لرسولك وحبيبك ونبيك وشفيعك ومصطفاك. You love to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would urge you to follow his sunnah literally. Literally. As he told us, can you imagine in this masjid, inshallah, we're planning to have Salatul Kusuf here, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. You go back 1400 years ago and you do as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. You live this time. You appreciate what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us. Not to, okay, let's find out, let's watch TV, let's watch, you know, the websites and online to find out what is going on and say, what Islam is saying? Relate to Islam, stick to Islam, follow Islam, learn from Islam, enhance your knowledge from Islam. As we'll add the other sources, like science. You combine both. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. There is another hadith of Nu'man ibn Bashir. قال صلى بنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الكسوف نحو صلاتكم يركع ويسجد ركعتين ركعتين ويسأل الله حتى تجلت الشمس. Another hadith, إذا رأيتم ذلك فصلوها كأحدث صلاة صليتموها من المكتوبة. What's really amazing about this salah, subhanallah, salat kusufu shams, the prayer of the total solar calendar. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu ardah, he was amir, the ruler, the governor of al-Basra, when they watch, they observe, they witness that total eclipse of the sun, فَخَرَجَ فَصَلَّى بِنَا رَكَعَتَيْنِ فِي كُلِّ رَكَعَةٍ رَكَعَتَيْنِ ثُمَّ رَكِبَ وَقَالَ إِنَّمَا صَلَّيْتُ كَمَا رَأَيْتُ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ رواه الشافعي. That's Ibn Abbas. Well, he was the governor of al-Basra at that time. When they witnessed that eclipse there, went to the masjid, had those two rak'at, and then he left, and then definitely, certainly, I performed that prayer as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. And this has been narrated in Al-Shafi'i fil Musnad. What is most likable when we have that salah? Again, I'm calling upon you, if you have the time, if you can take some time off to come to the masjid, we'll have jama'ah in here, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, Monday, of Salatul Dhuhr, inshallah, and then we'll have the Salat Kusuf al-Shams. Yustahabbu, what is most likable when we have the Salah before and after. Yustahabbu al-Takbir wal-Dua wal-Tasadduq wal-Istighfar. Allahu Akbar. Very, very highly recommended by Islam, by the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At-Takbir, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, as we do in Eid al-Adha wa Eid al-Fitr. What dua? Save your dua till that time, make as much dua as you can. There is a phenomena in this universe, there is something happening by the power, the absolute authority of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm witnessing such a thing. I relate to it. While I'm relating to it, make the dua. Because you're witnessing something, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about it, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In that time of the dua, your dua is accepted. Because you're part of witnessing those things. Not to keep busy, no, I'm sorry. I had already my lunch hour. I cannot come. I'm doing this and that. My employer will never allow me to go. Life is taking me away from everything. No. Take some time from your life, from your routine life. Come back to Allah, come back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-du'a wa al-tasadduq. Make sadaqah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that time as well. And don't ask me why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yani, has it chosen those things to do during and after the eclipse, either solar or lunar. Why du'a? Why tasadduq? And istighfar. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. Both three things. Dua, tasadduq, wa istighfar. This is a golden opportunity. Because we're witnessing ayah min ayatillah. You're witnessing a sign of the signs of Allah there. And as I mentioned before, it will never happen till about 7 years to come. And you never know whether you'll be living or alive for another 7 years in order to witness such a thing. Take an advantage of that opportunity in your dua and your sadaqah and your istighfar. And your istighfar. And this is actually narrated by Al-Bukhari wa Muslim عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فإذا رأيتم ذلك فادعوا الله وكبروا وتصدقوا وصلوا. That's the hadith of Aisha رضي الله عنها وأرضاه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. If you witness such a thing, make the takbirat, make the sadaqah, make the salah. Subhanallah. Same thing, Abi Musa رضي الله عنه وأرضاه إذا رأيتم شيئا من ذلك فأفزعوا إلى ذكر الله ودعائه واستغفاره اللهم إني قد بلغت اللهم فاشهد يا الله I have shared with you what I learned from رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم from فقه السنة from the Quran witness this enjoy it keep wondering give yourself some time to think of آيات الله في الكون. Don't listen to anyone saying that it is the laws of the nature. Here is the moon, here is the sun, here is, you know, the total eclipse, lunar or solar, and this is the act of nature, and we're watching, and we know when it happened, and why it happened, and where it happened, and for how long duration, and so on and so forth. All of these are fine, you know, we learn from it. But this is not the absolute reference for me. The absolute reference for us Muslims is to learn from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to learn from the Quran, to learn from the Sunnah, and in the same time, practice. Take advantage of such a thing. Because as I said before, it will happen again, hopefully in our life, in 7 years, but we never know. But we never know. So please, if you have time, come to the masjid, we'll be here. If you can take some time off, please do. Come and witness this wonderful prayer. Be indulged in the dua, in istighfar, in sadaqah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of us, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. Extend our life.